Gaddafi has repeatedly denied that he is a sponsor of terrorism. Yet he has provided aid to as many as 40 terrorist groups around the world. In his own country, disagreeing with government policy means getting thrown in jail. This man was accused of conspiring against the Gaddafi government. He was turned over to a lynch mob known as the People's Revolutionary Court. His home was also bulldozed. These scenes were broadcast nationwide on Libyan television as a reminder of what happens to so-called enemies of the revolution. Gaddafi is an outcast in the Arab world as well as in the West. Anwar Sadat called him crazy. The former president of Sudan called him a threat to the world. June 5th, 1984. In a basketball gymnasium, 30-year-old Sadiq Hamed Shouaidi is on trial, accused of crimes against the Libyan revolution. The trial was broadcast on Libyan national television. This black-and-white video is from a tape of the Libyan TV broadcast. In the early 80s, Shouaidi attended a small college in Tulsa, Oklahoma. While he was in the U.S., Shouaidi spoke out against the Gaddafi regime. He told friends he was going to do the same thing when he returned to Libya. 1 month before Shouaidi's arrest, a team of commandos tried, but failed, to storm Colonel Gaddafi's compound in Tripoli. The National Front for the Salvation of Libya, a group of anti-Gaddafi Libyans, claimed credit for the attack. Sadiq Shouaidi's cousin Majdi was one of those killed in the raid. At his so-called trial, with a mob chanting and jeering from the bleachers, and with his hands tied behind him, Shouaidi was forced to confess to plotting against the Libyan government. The crux of the charge is that while Shouaidi was in the United States, he participated in a series of secret meetings to plot the overthrow of Gaddafi. A translation of the Arabic reveals the Libyan gymnasium tribunal accused Shouaidi of traveling to the tiny Ohio town of Beloit, population 900, for one of the alleged plot meetings. And if you listen carefully, you can hear Shouaidi's accuser charging that he also attended a conspiracy meeting in what is described as Michigan, Ann Arbor. The trial didn't take long. 30-year-old Sadiq Hamed Shouaidi was hanged from a scaffold erected on the gymnasium floor. The reason for putting such a ghastly spectacle on national television is that it strikes fear in the hearts of Libyans both in and out of Libya. Just ask Yosef Shakir, an outspoken member of the National Front for the Salvation of Libya.